lots of confusion in my career path also. I think, but after what I changed, I thought this, after what I changed. So these types of confusion is a very common phenomena for any fresh graduates and also for the professionals as well, as because the mid-level career professionals, they sometimes become bored and think, should I go for further in this profession or I should change it? So this sort of many types of confusion arises. How we can remove this confusion from our career plan?
Yes, very valid question, sir, because career confusion definitely comes at all stages in life. With the students, yes, it comes in the form of what subjects to start because they don't want to make a wrong choice. With mid-year professionals, I think they fear facing a change. So they don't want to change. They don't want to turn to a different career. They want to continue being where they are. But in all of these, I think get to know yourself. It all starts from knowing yourself. If you don't know what you are and what you like, it will be very difficult for you to decide what's good for you. Most people do the mistake of selecting something that somebody else has taken, maybe one of their friends has taken, and with the assumption that, okay, he must have done some research and taken, but that guy has selected something that's probably good for him based upon his interest, his aptitude. What about you? You need to have that same research done for yourself and then decide what is it that you want to pursue. When you don't know what it is like to be in that role, in that job, it's very difficult to sit and gauge at a surface level. So your examples were very good. You did, when you looked from far, a policeman's job or the judge's job was something different from when you actually started doing it. So it is with all the other careers. When you actually get around to shadowing or doing internship, then it's a very, very different thing. So technology is very, very critical in all of this. Now we have, we have the way of conducting psychometric tests. We can find out what we are good at, what we can embark upon, what will be successful at. So getting some of these assessments, talking to people, all of these can help remove the confusion and help us decide or narrow down the choices, do the research, and then finally decide the option that we want to pursue. Also, I think one more thing I would like to bring here is that sometimes when you look at somebody who's, you know, I mentioned this before, is already in a position or a role that you want to look at, do have that chat, do have that conversation with them, if you can, as to what was the key lesson for them, what was difficult, how did they get where they got, what did they love about their job, what are the challenges that they face. So all these answers, all these conversations will give you an insight which no academic course or any online course can give you. So these are some of my suggestions that I hope can help create clear the career confusion that some of us may have.
Thank you. Exactly. Well, because if I don't know what type of personality I am at that standard, yeah, 9, it is really difficult to know about personality or to have a psychometric test to assess my career and my character similarities. So you have also mentioned one thing, that was career assessment. This is one thing. Second one, yeah, you have mentioned that get to know yourself, that means know thyself. As Socrates, yes, said before many years, yes, Socrates says, know thyself, know yourself, what you like, what you dislike, what you ought to be, what you don't ought to be. So this know thyself at standard 9, it is really hard question, but parents, teachers, coaches, guides, they can help it out. And
no, and these assessments also can help you become a little more self-aware. They do map your personality. you know, things like what is it that you like doing? Are you introvert, extrovert? Are you spontaneous? Do you like things organized? So these are all very, very essential information for yourself.
Yeah, but in the context of subcontinent, I mean, Bangladesh, India, or our neighboring countries, we usually, being familiar with all these sort of coaching, assessment, tests, after entering into a job, after 5 years of my career. But if these assessment can be done in the standard, I mean, at least undergrad level, then it could be
Can do these assessments. Or higher secondary level. Even in 9th standard onwards, you can do these tests. Overseas, they do it from 5th standard onwards.
Yeah, but in the subcontinent, we usually don't know whether this assessment is available, how to do it, how to pass it, where are a coaching career coach is there. Usually, we go to school or we come back from the school, we go to coaching center for academic coaching, not career coaching. Coaching center for academic coaching, and our only motto was just keep our CGPA in highest level. Just keep the result in the higher level. It is the only motto. And even not thinking about career, not thinking about anything. But after entering into career, we became familiar with all these sorts of. So could you please explain whether this sort of psychometric test or assessments or career counseling should be a part of your academic curriculum in standard 9 and above, so that you can become aware about these sort of activities and assess or know thyself, as you said, and then select your career in the bachelor level. So what is your comments?
So that is what I'm saying. So the landscape is actually changing. Now a lot of private schools have started getting career counseling done. They've not yet got into that very, very professional level, I must say. Usually one of the teachers is getting assigned. The only thing is that counseling is based only on academics. So the teacher may not know the psychology of the child or his other interests beyond academics, and then to be able to recommend a career stream for the child to start may not be 100% accurate. So which is why I think after conducting so many of these psychometric assessments for different children, which are usually 100% correct, I will say 99% because I always think there's scope for improvement. But and you know, the thing with the psychometric assessment is not that it is just going to say that, oh, you should do sciences and you should do arts or you should do commerce. It will say that in the field of humanities, these are the 2-3 things that are good for you. In the field of sciences, this is what would be good for you. Or if you want to pursue commerce, then maybe finance is good, but not accounting, you know, things like that. So your choices get filtered through different, checks like your personality, your type of working, what kind of a learner you are, what is your value, career values, what kind of work environment do you like, and things like that. And these psychometric assessments would be different for students in the 9th standard, different for students in the 12th standard, and of course, different for working professionals. But all in all, they are very accurate, and I will highly recommend that anybody who has even an iota of confusion in what career, what things to decide or pursue, they should take that.
Thank you, ma'am. At this moment, I would like to know about career rut. What is career rut, and how does one get out of it?
So, career rut is actually a phase that some people go through when you feel unproductive or you feel dull, and maybe your career is not progressing at the pace that you would like it. So it can be difficult to get out of if you don't address it quickly, because maybe it's fear, it's lack of confidence, it could be self-limiting beliefs, which cause this inability to move forward. But there is a way out of a career rut. And I'll give you 5 5 tips for getting out of it quickly. First, you need to check whether you are in a career rut by identifying what is the source of it. You know, is it because you think you're getting, maybe you're getting underpaid than the rest of colleagues in that same position? Or you're not really feeling passionate about the job as you did a couple of months or a couple of years back? You're not feeling challenged. If you have something you're doing in a very monotonous way, it's not inspiring you enough. Or you foresee that there is no more growth for you in your current organization. That can also, dull your feelings for the job. Then there could be different factors. For example, if you were, you had a talk with your manager, you probably discussed maybe promotion or a raise, but somehow it didn't happen. Or you may have been looking for a different kind of a role or a different kind of a job, but unfortunately you're not getting through to the interviews. So these all, contribute to feeling a lack of confidence and feeling a bit let down. And these are what add up to, being in a career.